doctor.
Not an easy hand to be dealt. Belinda's a patient of yours, Helen,
yes.
And we know that there isn't a particular cause for chronic fatigue syndrome, but there are triggers and predisposing factors, aren't there?
Absolutely. And often it'll be the type A personality who's overworked and often, you know, not getting enough sleep, not eating properly, not exercising enough.
Like Belinda, like you.
Like Belinda, like myself, probably like you.
Yes.
And then what happens is that they actually are, their immune system is just more vulnerable to being infected with viruses and bacteria. And they start developing these infections or develop chronic infections, and the immune system just can't actually deal with that.
Okay.
So, you know, is it actually the virus or is it the immune system?
Yeah. What are the symptoms of chronic fatigue syndrome? How do I know I'm developing something that's just not right?
Well, I think, you know, as the name says, you've got chronic fatigue for at least 6 months.
Okay.
Okay, and then you add on another 8 symptoms. So you're getting things like chronic unrefreshed sleep. You're waking up in the morning, you're still exhausted. You're getting headaches. Headaches that maybe you never had before, or they're suddenly different.
Okay.
Poor concentration and lack of memory is a huge problem, and the patients often come to us with that. And then they complain that every time they get sick, they've got a lot of lymph nodes, whether it's in the neck or under the arms. They're getting sore throats. Whenever they've overexerted or done too much, they're getting a sore
That's
throat.
Right.
They're waking
up
the
sore throat,
the Monday morning sore throat. And then they also start saying that they've suddenly got muscle pains. They're not doing any exercise. They've got no time to exercise, and they're getting unexplained muscle pains. They're getting joint pains, which they've never had before. And it's not the joint pains of an arthritis where it's red and swollen. They're just joint
That's
pains.
Yeah.
But most importantly, I think this is the one that, you know, patients should be aware of, is just absolute extreme exhaustion after any mental exertion or after any physical exertion, yeah.
Okay, so maybe I've ticked off a couple of those symptoms. What do I do now? Because there are so many general practitioners and doctors who don't quite believe in yappy flu or chronic fatigue syndrome because you can't diagnose it or you can't test it in the lab.
Yeah, I think it is incredibly important to go and see your healthcare provider because, as we've just said, there isn't really one specific test that you can do. Mm. You can check your DHEA levels, your cortisone levels. These will help. But more importantly, chronic fatigue could also be a symptom of something more ominous.
That's right.
So I think the blood tests and going to your GP are more important in terms of excluding the baddies, because those things could be giving you the chronic fatigue.
That's right.
I mean, depression also presents with fatigue.
Yeah.
You know, that needs to be
cancers. You know,
exactly. So that needs to be excluded, and almost it'll be a diagnosis of exclusion, because they'll go to the symptom profile.
All right. So diagnosis is made. Now what? How do we manage this? Is this treatable?
Well, I definitely believe it is treatable, and I've had a lot of patients that do, but unfortunately there's no golden magic bullet.
Sure.
And this is what patients come there, especially the type A's are the ones who are getting it. That sort of profile, more females than men,
okay.
And that sort of 30 to 50 age group. Those girls are all racing after their careers, the overworked businessman,
sure.
And they have to now change their lifestyle. How do you do that? Because you've got the deadline still.
That's right.
It's not as if you're changing your job. And that is where the challenge comes in. And I think that if your healthcare provider is not able to help you with that, get some help. Go and see a life coach. Go and see a psychologist if necessary. Get your mood disturbance sorted out, because all of these things are going to help. But you have to go back to basics. Have a look at your diet. Am I eating the same things every day? Because often we know that there will be a gut abnormality. And with a gut abnormality in these kind of illnesses, it all goes around this whole inflammatory cascade, which I'm sure you've talked about.
It's a knock-on effect, yeah.
It's a knock-on effect. And then if you're eating, for instance, all bran every day, I don't want to knock the all bran, but you don't want to eat it every day, every third day, because otherwise you're going to develop a sensitivity to it.
That's right.
So variety in diet. Very important.
Okay.
Look at your exercise. What are you doing? Are
That's
you
right.
not doing anything the whole week, and then suddenly you're running a half marathon on a Saturday?
That's right. Don't overdo it, because that exacerbates the condition.
It's going to exacerbate it.
Okay.
So you need to actually slow down on the aerobic exercise. Maybe go back to a bit of cross training. Do some weight training. Do some yoga. Do some Tai Chi, and cut back on the aerobic exercise, because we know that's going to give you more fatigue.
That's right.
Have a look at your sleep hygiene, because we know that these patients are often getting home at 6 o'clock, wolfing down some dinner, going to the gym, getting home, doing some homework maybe with the children, and then they're getting to bed at 12 o'clock. We know that your brain needs that 10 to 12 o'clock to actually renew itself.
That's right.
Make sure you get into bed earlier, even if it's only 3 days of the week.
Sure.
You can't go from 12 o'clock every night to suddenly 10 o'clock.
No, you can't.
But you're going to try and make an effort
Adjust.
To do it. Yeah.
Wow, so there's a massive lifestyle change. What about there must be some sort of pill or pills you can take to help?
I always say to my patients that we have to start by looking at the lifestyle, because I think it is important to do that first. Because if you don't change the lifestyle, I can give you a huge amount of supplements and herbal remedies, they're not going to make a difference. So you have to look at the fact that the patient has done that. Now you say to them, okay, what can I offer you in terms of a supplement or a herbal remedy? And I always give them a very good vitamin B supplement. I have a look at what they are taking in terms of minerals as well, and exclude anemia because they might be a little bit anemic as well.
Sure.
And then we look at the herbal remedies. There are a lot of herbal remedies that you can use depending on where you are in the adrenal burnout phase. So you'll need to chat to someone about that. But we know that one of the common ones is Panax ginseng. And I'm saying Panax ginseng because there are various ginsengs on the market. Just please be careful if you have got hypertension, high blood pressure, as these kind of things are not allowed to be taken by those patients, and especially also not by pregnant women. That hopefully won't get chronic fatigue.
Helen, I'm stepping back thinking, wow, I tick far too many of those boxes, and I know there are many people that do the same thing. Give us a bit of hope in terms of prognosis. Can this be beaten, and how long?
Well, I always say to my patients that you definitely can get back to where you were beforehand. A lot of people say you can't cure it. I think that if you actually are very good about your lifestyle, you can get back to where you were before.
And you're walking testimony of that, aren't you?
Yes, I have done it before as well. And but I do think that you've got to be prepared to put aside a year to actually get better. And that might mean that you can't run for a year if you're a runner.
Wow.
Until a runner, they can't run for a year, they actually go into depression and need something for that. But you're going to have to do that, because if you want to run for the rest of your life, you're going to have to give it up for a year. And then you're going to, maybe this would be a time of growth. You could experience some other things. Maybe go hiking or the Tai Chi and, you know, do some other things. So there's always going to be a positive spin-off, but it definitely can be treated, but you need to get help with it. You won't be able to do it on your own.
And it's a serious condition. So Helen, thank you. Really appreciate that. Appreciate those insights.
Sure.
Chronic fatigue syndrome, man. Can neither be prevented nor cured, and prognosis is long-term management. So be careful of a misdiagnosis. Get a second opinion if you must, because you don't want to limp through life unnecessarily.
Cipla. We'll make it better.